So I've been working on a design to enter the speaker cover design contest recently put up by the 3D printing nerd. In my design, I had to selectively pattern a certain region. In an earlier video that I did on pattern masking, I took a series of steps that involved copying the original body and a few multi-body operations. Working on this new design has given me some new insight that has allowed me to come up with an alternative workflow. I want to thank NorMaker, who provided the original inspiration for this video. First of all, take note that we are starting off with a curved plate. If this was a flat plate, we can simply perform an extrude to mask off the area that does not require the pattern. For this new method, there is no need to create a copy of the body. I have prepared a sketch here, which defines the area where the pattern needs to be. Let's split the body with this sketch. Go to Modify, Split Body. Select the plate as a body to split. For splitting tool, click on the select box and select the sketch. Let's rename the two separate bodies. Perform a sketch on the top plane for the seat or starting feature. This is going to be a hexagonal cut. Center the hexagon on the origin. Enter the number of sides and dimension it. I will set a horizontal constraint on this edge. Draw a line from the center to the midpoint of this horizontal line. Draw another line from the center to the midpoint of the adjacent line. Control select these two lines and press X to change them to construction. These two lines will serve as directions during the pattern command. Exit the sketch and use this profile to perform an extruder cut. After some testing, I have found that the pattern command tends to handle the true or extent with unpredictable results. So I will extend the extrude to an arbitrary distance instead. Under Objects to Cut, you can see the inner body and a checked box next to it. This is the only body that lies in the path of the extrude, so there's only one option here. Keep this in mind when we perform the pattern. Go to Create, Pattern, Rectangular Pattern. For type, select features and select the extruder cut. For directions, click on the select box. Unhide the hexagonal sketch and select the two lines as the directions. I will be using spacing as a distance type. For direction type, I will be using symmetric in both directions. It is up to you to adjust the parameters for your own design. The most important thing to take note here is to adjust the pattern such that it fully encompasses the required region, which is a circle in this example. I will set the compute option as optimized for the moment. You can see that the pattern only cuts through the inner body. Both the identical and adjust options produce the same result. Let's cast our minds back to the previous extrude command, where we had given a specific instruction for it to cut through only the inner body. You can argue that this is the only body that lies in the path of the extrude, and that the command has no choice. But to the command, this is an explicit instruction. Since we are patterning features, every single one of these pattern features will continue to follow that instruction, bypassing the outer body, even when we adjusted the pattern beyond the inner body. For now, these are still two separate bodies. Go to Modify, Combine. Select these two bodies and join them into a single body. For a more convincing example, let's try to place a C feature right in the middle of the two bodies. In this case, the sketch profile straddles both the inner and outer bodies. When we perform the extruder cut, under Objects to Cut, we will see both bodies, since both bodies lie in the extrusion path. Let's uncheck the outer body, so that the extrude only cuts through the inner body. Let's repeat the rectangular pattern. As before, adjust the pattern to ensure that it fully encompasses the inner body. In this case, I found that only the identical and adjust options would work to get the required result. I did not have any luck with the optimized option. Do try this and let me know in the comments. As another test, let's go back into the extrude feature and choose the outer body instead. And let the pattern regenerate. As a final test, let's choose both bodies. As you might have guessed, there is a limitation to this workflow. What happens if you have two or more separate regions? In this case, the workflow that I have presented thus far would only work if the C feature is large enough to straddle across multiple regions. If that is not the case, and the C feature is not big enough, one option will be to do two separate pattern features. Of course, that will lead to problems with misalignment between the two patterns. In that case, I would actually recommend to use a workflow presented in the original pattern masking video. For a more detailed workflow, please refer to that video. I will perform a quick demonstration here. First, let's create a copy of this plate. Select the body in the Bodies folder. Press Ctrl-C to copy and Ctrl-V to paste. When the Move Copy command window shows up, click OK to accept the copy in the same location as the original. Rename both bodies. Let's hide the copy and perform the pattern on the original. As before, make sure that the pattern exceeds the area that you plan for. In this case, we did not perform any split bodies, so the pattern is going to cut through the whole plate. Let's hide this body and bring back the copy. So this is a sketch that defines the two regions where we need the pattern to be reviewed. We will perform an extruder cut with the two closed profiles. Bring back the original body. We can see that the pattern is rebuilt in the regions where the cuts have been made. We need to combine both bodies so that the unwanted patterns can be filled back in.